So this is going to be an interesting one. You either watch them, jump into them, or duck and cover until they're put out. What am I talking about? Trash fires, of course, and not the ones behind your house, but the ones on the internet. Oh, do the flames fly high as the shit show is egged on by varying guests and onlookers. I used to get a kick out of them, but not so much anymore. I'll still watch one or two of them, but boy, do they get exhausting to follow. So much to read upon, as in more cases than one. You have a constant deluge of threads and videos to catch up on if you really want to know everything about one situation. With that being said, I find it best nowadays to simply disappear. Possibly be an onlooker, but make myself quiet and invisible, especially if it has nothing to do with me. I've managed to shrink myself down in situations that I was involved with to a good degree where eyes were focused elsewhere. I like having followers and subs, but I'm not too keen on being the center of attention. Past events have proven that it's way too much for me, as I can become very stupid and overwhelmed. Now, with that being said, I've taken a step back from a lot of different areas of the web. I'll still look at threads, but do so quietly. Half the time, I can't make out how things got started and what led to certain individuals to start fighting with each other. It always amazes me who and where the fighting occurs. Now, please don't take this video as a knock if you do constantly jump in the fire. More power to you if you don't get burned. It's just for me, constantly sticking my head in that sort of thing gets to be too much. I do have the tendency to poke my head in at the wrong times, which is a habit I severely need to kill. Anyway, with me making myself invisible, it was a habit I developed growing up. When it came to my teen years, I was really socially awkward and really didn't fit in with my peers. I know that's cliche as hell, but my awkwardness stemmed from my lack of being able to relate to my peers, much more my own age range. It was rare if I got along with anyone my own age. I just didn't do the same things they did, nor get into the same kind of trouble. I grew up in a strict Christian household, so you'd think I'd be able to make friends in the church. Nope, that was actually the last place I could do it, seeing how my parents' rules didn't make sense in regards to having friends and who I can be friends with. No, the more my struggles became clear to me in some ways, then confused the hell out of me in others, I pretty much figured that I was on my own. I really couldn't share my origin story with anyone without being gawked at. What came out of my mouth, my parents certainly didn't understand either, along with my siblings. My struggles also resulted in some rather strange behaviors due to me not being able to cope with what happened to me properly. Speaking of family, whenever fights broke out that didn't have to do with me, my ass was gone. I'd either go in my room or leave the house. I wasn't really interested in listening to yelling. I would catch snippets here and there, but I'd pretty much become scarce if I could. Not to say that there was always fighting, but still, I remember at one point being asked my opinion on something by one family member, only for another to interrupt, saying that I had no idea what was going on because I was always in my room. Going back to my Christian upbringing, especially church-wise, due to my inability to properly voice what I was struggling with, on top of not having certain pieces of knowledge, I was very much seen as odd. That being coupled with the fact that I dressed more boyish back then, keeping my hair extremely short, nearly pixie cut, it came to my attention that people had begun to whisper about me, trying to figure out whether or not I was gay or struggling with being gay. My parents alerted me to this after they tried to joke with me about something to which I was having none of it. I've also had leaders back off me due to my need for help that was way over their head, or way more than they could provide. If I could make myself invisible at church, I did. Now, the only thing I will say that really bugged me is that I found out people took notice, but never said anything. I already felt out of place, slowly backing away, only for these people to go, "Oh well." I've come to loathe pretty much any church setting at this point, with many more reasons that would be added later on down the road. Anyway, for me, connecting to people is very difficult. I usually keep people at an arm's length just in case. I'm one of those, once shit hits the fan and has nothing to do with me, I'm out. I know that sounds horrible to a lot of people. I can actually make one look bad, as it has done. Honestly, it's just my way of avoiding more trouble when I already have enough of my own. Something I have noticed with me going quiet is that I get associated with other people's bad behavior, or rather being okay with it. I've had people get onto me for not saying something or calling people out when I'm on good speaking terms with said individual. It's really annoying, not to mention stresses me out. I don't want to be part of the shit flinging, thanks. Whatever issues you have with them has nothing to do with me. It's guilt by association. If you're having an argument with them and I'm not, keep me out of your beef with them. I don't care or condone what they might or might not be doing. I'm standing in my corner for a reason. I've either settled my beef with them or never had any issues with them to begin with. Honestly, the shit gets old. There are certain things I voice my concerns on and may even speak with said parties or party if I'm inclined to, but that's about it. I have really bad social anxiety, which can really flare up. I keep my distance as best as I can not to get wrapped up with what may be going on. I know that sounds really bad, but it's a tactic I've learned to do and it's also kept me out of trouble for the most part. Lord knows I've gotten myself into enough of it. Now, with all of this being said, making myself invisible can backfire at times. Such times include when I'm really in a bind or in a really dark place and there's no one really to turn to. Anyway, I wish I had more people to talk to, but then remember how much that can blow up in my face. I've lost many relationships over these past few years due to family drama or personal differences between friends. At this point, I find having certain types of relationships to be pointless either because I've never had them or they were too much of a headache for me. Making myself pretty much a ghost has resulted in me not having to deal with a lot of bullshit, whether it be family-wise or otherwise. I love my family, and even though there are major issues, but at points I've gone dark or cut the line when I've seen things as pointless or just too overwhelming. You can throw extremely upsetting in there too. Over the course of my life, I've learned to go without a lot of social aspects any normal person would experience, whether that's social events or just being involved. Take, for example, parties. I'll go if I'm invited, which I can't remember the last one I was actually invited to, but having one for myself, yeah, just no, don't even think about throwing me one. I will find a hole to go hide in until it's over. The last one I actually remember having was my 18th birthday. My graduation party was combined with my 18th birthday. I really didn't want one, but didn't have the heart to tell my parents. I knew it would be awkward for me, seeing how I was a loner in high school. You try going to 5 to 6 different ones and see how well you fare. Anyway, we had a few relatives over, with maybe one or two people over from my youth group. I was not allowed to stay in my room. I felt so weird sitting there receiving items that I knew I was not going to use or more than likely going to get rid of later. I was not girly in my teens, but certain relatives insisted on buying me girly shit. I felt like people were trying to put me into some sort of feminine box to which I did not want to go in, and constantly fought people on. That also caused a lot of people to back off when I would put up a fuss. Instead of trying to force me into some sort of pink mold, why not try to understand why I don't want to do the same things the other girls do? I could go on about that one forever, telling what and why there were so many issues there, but I just might save that for another video. We'll see. Making oneself invisible on purpose isn't necessarily a bad thing. It does suck when it happens on accident or when others do it to you on purpose. For me, I pretty much did it to myself after varying mishaps or constant struggles socially. These days, I find myself keeping my mouth shut more and more, seeing how I just don't have the energy nor want to waste the energy on it. I probably just made myself look like a really huge asshole with this one, but I'm being honest. I'm not going to screech about everything that happens, nor will I get involved with everything that may go down. I have enough locked away that makes me feel bogged down at times. So in my mind, it's better for me to just go quiet, tuning all the madness and everyone's BS out. It's less stressful for me. Sorry if this puts anyone off, but I hope it gives you a better perspective. Well, that's enough rambling for now. See you in the next one.